I want everyone to perform this. Check whether the schedule number 2 also keeps the database in a consistent state or not. Any questions, students, in this task? It is very easy because we already seen one check of schedule number 1 for consistency check in previous lecture. Now we are checking it for second schedule, which is also a serial schedule. Here we are checking whether this also keeps the database in a consistent state or not. And the final conclusion will be made from schedule number 1 and 2 that all the serial schedules keep the database in a consistent state. In schedule 2, if you see, the first statement that we are going to execute here is read A operation. Again, we will consider the initial balances of account A and account B as 1000 and 2000. Balance in account A as 1000 rupees, whereas and in account B as 2000 rupees. And again, execute the statements, instructions given in the transaction T2. Apply these values in the transaction. Now we are performing read A operation. When you read the balance of A, it will show you 1000 rupees in transaction T2. Before starting the transaction T2, if I take the balance of account A and account B, sum of balance of account A and account B, it would be 1000 plus 2000 rupees, that goes to 3000. Now let us perform the instructions from account A, that is, we are executing the instructions on transaction T2. Here we are performing read A. So when you perform read A, it will show you. It will show you 1000 rupees in account A. Right. Then we have another statement, that is find the 10% of account A balance. So here, if I apply that formula, temp equal to A into 0.10. So it goes to 1000 into 0.10, and it is 100 rupees. So we found the 10% of the account is balanced. And then third statement is we want to subtract this temp value from account A. So here A equal to A minus temp, if I write, then it will go to 1000 minus 100, and it is 900 rupees in account A. But it is still not updated. It will be updated only when you execute this write A operation. So if you see here, there is another operation in transaction T2, that is write A, fourth line in transaction T2, write A. So when I perform write A operation, value of account A becomes 900 rupees. Again, in transaction P2, there are some lines remain. That is, we go to account B, we read account B, perform read B operation on account B. There you will find it is 2000 rupees, initial balance, 2000 rupees. Then we have another line, that is B equal to B plus 10. So here it becomes B equal to B plus 10, and that goes to 2000 rupees plus temp value is 100 rupees, that is 10% of account A, and total goes to 2100. Still it is not updated because it will be updated only when you write B operation. So the last line in transaction T2 is write B operation. So here I am performing write B, and then it gets updated as 2100 in account B. So if you see, all the instructions from account B are now over. Let us check what are the balances in account A plus B after performing transaction P2. After performing the transaction P2, A plus B equals to, we have to look for this statement after updation. What is there in account A? It is 900 rupees. What is there in account B? It is 2100. So it goes to 900 plus 2100. Total is 3000 rupees. Now let's check. Before performing the transaction T2, we calculated the balances of sum of balance of account A and account B. It was 3000 rupees. Now, after performing transaction T2, again we checked for the sum of balance of account A and account B. It is matching. It is showing 3000 rupees. It means that from this, we can say that transaction P2 keeps the database in consistency. So we checked it for transaction P2. Only one is remained now, that is, we have to also check it for transaction P1. Now we are going to transaction P1. In transaction P1, let us see what is the instruction, first instruction in transaction T1. It is read A operation. So here I am going to write read A operation. So before that, again, we have to write this line before performing the transaction T1. Let us calculate the balances in account A and account B. Before performing transaction T1, account A was 900 rupees, and in account B, there was 2100, and total goes to 3000. Let us start transaction P1. The first instruction is read A. Here I am writing read A operation. When I write read A, I will get 900 rupees as the balance in account A. Then the next statement is subtract 50 rupees from account A. A equal to A minus 50. That goes to 900 minus 50. Total is 850 rupees remaining in account B. Still it is not updated. We have to perform write A operation, then only it gets updated into account A. Now we are performing write A operation. Now it gets updated in account B. The next statement in transaction T1 in this schedule is read B operation. Now we perform read B operation. Here we'll get the balance of account B as 2100, updated balance. Then we add 50 rupees into it. The next statement in transaction T1 is add 50 rupees in account B. So B becomes B equals to B plus 50. goes to 21100 plus. It goes to 2150. Okay. Now we calculated the balance of account A and account B in transaction T1 of schedule 2. Let us find the sum of balances of account A and account B after transaction T1. Here I'm writing, you have to write B. Last operation from transaction T1, write B. When you do that, the balance is updated into account B. And now, after performing transaction T1 from schedule number 2, the updated balances are 850 in account A plus 2150 in account B. If you add these two amounts, the total goes to 3000 rupees. So it means that again, before performing the transaction T1 and after performing the transaction T1 in schedule number 2, the balances, sum of balances are again same. It means that this transaction T1 also keeps the database in consistent state. So you can write here the next line. Transaction T1. T1 keeps the database in consistency. So at the end, we can say that in schedule S2, both the transactions T1 and T2 keeps the database. Keep the database in consistent state. Hence, the schedule S2, which is a serial schedule, keeps the database inconsistent state. So this is our answer for schedule number 2. Our job was to check whether this schedule S2 keeps the database in a consistent state or not, where we are executing all the instructions of T1 first and then we are executing transaction T1. So T2 first and then followed by T1. And we checked for all the instructions of T2 first and then we checked it for all the instructions of T1. And we come to a final conclusion that both the transactions in schedule S2 keeps the database in a consistent state. Hence, we can say that the schedule S2, which is a serial schedule, also keeps the database in consistent state. Now let us come to the final conclusion of our given problem. That was the statement given to us. The execution of serial schedule always keeps the database in consistent state. And we found that in a schedule, there are suppose transaction T1 and T2. We checked it in schedule S1, where we executed all the instructions of T1 and then followed by T2. T1 first and T2 later. In schedule S2, we check T2 first and T1 later. It means all the instructions of T2 gets executed first and then T1. And both were serial schedule. And we come to know that both the serial schedules keep the database in consistent state. It means that for all the possible combinations of schedules for two transactions, we check all possibilities and we come to know that it keeps the database in a consistent state. So we can say that this particular statement given to us in the problem is true. The execution of serial schedules always keeps your database in consistent state. Okay, so this statement is true. If this question is asked for